Right then. We've got Slime. Slime was the boss. Are we back? Yes. The stream's been pretty good the last few streams of, like, not crashing. But, yeah, today, clearly that's not the case. So I can't... Not doing any clicking off of the game. Right. Start with Ironclad. Going for Slime. Let's play smart. Remove a card from your deck. Max HP plus 7. Take 18. Gain 14 max. Or lose your starting run-up for a boss relic. Ugh. I don't really like these. Still racing carts. I've been occasionally. Occasionally playing, doing some carts. Occasionally playing some squash. It's my birthday at the weekend, so I've got some people coming around for drinks and games. Should be fun. Other than that, not really. See my dad occasionally. Watch some football every now and then. I'm turning 28. Yes, I'm 27 currently. Seabsman, good morning. How are we doing? Right, what are we doing here? Honestly, this might be a random boss relic. I don't really like the others. It's a shame to lose the Burning Blood, but we're gonna do it. Okay, Fusion Hammer. Can't upgrade. So anything that relies on an upgrade, we can't really go for. We don't heal after combat. That's such a big deal. Battle trance is good. But having lots of energy means we can play more cards and play more expensive cards. Shrug it off is just always good. Right, wait, is anyone else here? Or is it just Jolly? Is this stream dead for everyone?
The hell's going on?
Probably shrug it off. Yeah, definitely shrug it off. Private stream? Hey, Jolly, it's just me and you. How are you doing today? Right. Oh, hey, Cyan, what's up? Right, okay. Yeah, not having Burning Blood really means we need more block, definitely. And we need to kill things faster. Probably means we need to rest more at campsites. Ooh, Flame Barrier, Second Wind, Warcry. So Flame Barrier is quite nice here. Gotta remember we can never upgrade it. But it's probably still fine to take unupgraded. Do a couple of events. Throw something into the bonfire. I'm gonna throw a strike in. It's a bit dodgy though. Like, we might want to save this fire potion for the slime because we don't have much damage yet. I'm not sure we're even kit out to do an elite yet. We can use the fire potion on elite, actually. Let's do it. Oh, sure. Hemokinesis. So, losing 2 HP is a lot less good when, we don't have our passive healing. So, it's probably shrug it off and remove a card. What should we remove? Maybe remove a defend now. Then again, we got a lot of block. Like, shrug, shrug, flame barrier. This could definitely be a body slam deck. Don't want the damage to be too low, though. I think we probably should remove a defend here. Yeah. Oh god, Nob's gonna be hard. This is a fight where we're glad we removed a defend. Probably gonna need to use the fire potion. I mean, we might even just drop a land even. So see if we flame barrier here. Probably do it. For the 4 damage back. Strike, strike. Just need one more aggressive card here. Okay. Strike, strike. Strike. Okay. Using the potions to get through the elites here. Gambling chip. The start of each combat, discard any number of cards and draw that many. Nice. Power potion's a good one. Uppercut. Uppercut's really good upgraded. But we can't upgrade anything. Not terrible unupgraded. Can't upgrade anything. Maybe we should take it. I'm gonna take it. Right, should we go for a second elite? Campfires are not as useful for us anymore. Let's go this way, not go to the campfire. Honestly, even this kind of fight's gonna be, this is gonna have a hard fight for this early on. I'm thinking about using the power potion now. But if we get through this fight, okay, we could do an elite after. There's not many heals coming up. Whether I want to take this 14 damage or not. I could just try and have the slime dead next turn. Or we try and block a lot of this. So 3 strikes would do it. Nice. Okay, trying to block that out as much as we can. Bash or uppercut? Don't need them weak, so probably bash. Yeah, the uppercut hasn't been that good so far, to be fair. Go This is a really bad draw because we drew a lot of block that turn. Oh, terrible. I need to hit some block here. Oh, God. That was just unfortunate sequence of draws there. Obgur really wants an upgrade. It does, but we can never upgrade it this run, unfortunately. Rampage, and we've Headbutt. I'm gonna skip. Right, we'll go for an Elite. We're gonna have to use a potion, I think. I think we've gotta use a power potion here. These are pretty weak. Start smacking it next turn. Bash. Right, do we strike or shrug? Probably shrug. Might start doing damage now. Okay. Hopefully we kill it next turn. Unceasing top. Whenever you have no cards in hand, draw a card. Ooh. That's interesting. Can we really build around that at this stage? And we would unceasing top really would want lots of zero cost cards. Although here it's hard to not take Impervious. Spot weakness is alright. But not against the slime boss, really. I'm gonna take Impervious. Alright, get a relic. If your HP is at below 50% or less, heal 12. That's big! Getting some kind of healing is really good, because we don't have any, because we don't have Burning Blood. Remove a card, transform a card, upgrade a card. Well, because we can never upgrade cards, is it ever upgrade uppercut? Impervious is pretty good without upgrading. Baltrad's pretty good without upgrading. I think uppercut is the card that benefits the most by being upgraded. Although Flame Barrier is pretty decent as well. Our relics are complete, not so far. I don't know. I mean, Unceasing Top is basically useless at the moment. But Gambling Chip is very, very good, and this is very, very good for sure. I think I'm going to upgrade. I very, very rarely pick upgrade from this. I would almost always remove. Sometimes transform. But I think this is one more I'm actually going to upgrade. Alright, Uppercut Plus, let's go. Right, we can go do one more Elite. Do we want to get to this campfire? With the meat on the bone, it's going to keep us a little bit healthy. We've got a weak pot. I think we do want to go for one more Elite. Like we could dodge the Elite by doing like enemy, enemy, campfire. And honestly, it might be better to get right and do a vent into shop. Into burning elite. Ugh. It doesn't look nice, but it might be the play here. I'm gonna do the event. Oh, it's a shop. Okay. Ooh, body. This is a really good deck for body slam. Shrug it off on sale. Wow, this. We got some big decisions to make here. We've got big, big decisions to make here. With not much healing, Waffle is really good. Vajra is just straight damage. Wow, this is hard. I think probably because removing a card is quite expensive at this point, we probably don't do remove a card. So it's either Vajra or Waffle. Well, we could remove a card if we went Body Slam. This just feels so much like a Body Slam deck. We've got Impervious, we've got two Shrugs, we've got Flame Barrier. We can have another Shrug here. Vajra is just damage. But with the amount of block we got. Also, a second shop coming to save a gold is not bad. I think this shop's good enough. I think we can splash out here. Man, it's basically, I'm basically deciding between Vajra, Waffle, and Slam. The Slam option also includes a remove. So it's Vajra, Waffle, or Slam remove. We're going to get Shrug no matter what, I think. Especially because it's on sale. Wait, can I afford Shrug with any of the options? 170. Oh, it's exact, actually. With the Vajra and the Waffle and the Shrug, it's exact gold. With the Body Slam and the card remove, it's... Yeah, one under. Because it's 156. I think I would go Waffle over Vajra. You could just go slam, skip the remove, and save some gold for the next shot. That's true. That's true. I'm gonna go. My heart says Slam Shrug, man. My heart says Slam Shrug. Right, do we want to go for the Burning Elite? I mean, we could not go for the Burning Elite. And go this way and have more enemies. And skip this next shop. Like, I don't have to do the shop. I mean, these are going to be hard fights. Like, all three of these. Like, the Elite's obviously hard. And then the other two fights are going to be quite hard fights. But we are quite strong now. So I think we could just remove a strike and fight. We're pretty strong. And we got meat on the bone, and we got weak potion. So let's remove a strike. Body slam. Zero streak, right? Yes, we are on a zero streak at the moment. Okay. I feel like we've had quite a good start here. To say the fusion hammer is a bit risky. Okay, cultist potion. Dropkick. Do we want dropkick? I've got two cards that apply vulnerable, rather than the normal one. But we don't really need it when we're doing all this block stuff. I'd rather focus on the block stuff, to be honest. It's just annoying if we draw it and they're not vulnerable. It's not, we don't have any strength gains, it's not doing that much. I'm gonna skip it. Okay, sentries. Is sentries good or bad for us? I'm not actually sure. Probably gonna... We'll probably try and save both the potions here. I mean, uppercut, we're like the weak of the vulnerable. It's because of their artifacts. The weak of the vulnerable is kind of hard to get rid of. Kill one of them. Not bad. Having lots of blocks good in this fight as well, because you're not in like a rush. Like with the Knob and the Lagavulin, like they just do so much damage. Whereas this fight, and they like scale more as well. This fight doesn't really scale so much. Slime's gonna be interesting because normally you wanna do loads of damage and pop it quickly, but this deck can't actually do that. Well, actually, maybe we could. If we do, like, if we have, like, uppercut bash the first couple of turns, then set up, like, a massive body slam, that's a possibility, I guess. And we can, we'll probably use the ritual potion on the boss. Yeah, take a bit of damage here. We're also gonna remember we're gonna be resting a lot of rest sites, because the fusion hammer, like, we're just naturally gonna rest. We can't upgrade. So I, maybe that means I can be a little bit riskier. Because a lot of the time at campsites you're hoping for an upgrade. I really like the body slam. I'm glad we added the body slam. Blood fire. Hey, that's some healing. Another shrug it off or inflame. It's gotta be another shrug it off. Just take all the shrugs. We've got four shrugs already. I'm just always happy playing shrug. It's just always a good card. Impervious. Nice. Twin Strike, Warcry, Havoc. Hello, Demodius. How are you? What's going on? It's probably a skip. Okay, campfire. Can we ever recall here? Because we can't upgrade. We could recall if we think we're going to win this fight, no problem. No need. But we might want to heal later on. It's maybe just unnecessarily greedy. You might get one at full health. Yeah, we might do.
But if we can do this, nah, we should probably just rest. Because we don't have that much upfront damage, I think we probably rest. We could just smash it though. We might end up just smashing it. It's real fast. Bad draws, turn one. Wanted bash or thingy there. Oh god, bad draws. Okay. With these draws, I'm definitely glad we healed. Play the slimes. Probably pop it next turn. Oh my god. Oh god. Okay. We probably pop it here. I'm not popping it that much, but probably do it. 65. And we've got this gradual strength gain, so we will just get stronger and stronger. Solid. Oh, I should have strike that actually. Okay, nice. Nearly there. Nearly there. And we're there. Okay, solid. So, we could have got away without healing, but it was probably best to play it safe. Reaper, Fiend, Fire, Bludgeon. Important decision here. Because we've got no strength gain. So Reaper isn't that great. We've got a lot of block. Like, I would have much preferred... Like, Barricade would have been the nuts here. Offering would have been really good. Maybe it's Fiendfire. Gonna exhaust certain cards in our deck. To make the deck smaller. Exhaust, like, the strikes. Bludgeon's better in Act 1 than Act 2. Fiendfire works with top. Oh, true! I don't think that's a massive deal, but I think Fiendfire is probably the pick anyway for this deck. They're all not perfect, but Fiendfire is probably the best. Sozu Sacred Bark, Black Star. Ooh. Now, this is interesting because we've already got 4 energy. I mean, more energy is always good. More energy is always good, especially when you've got multiple 2 cost cards in the deck. Easy, Sozu. Like, this could actually be a Black Star run. Why did the child change? Did you achieve 4 in a row? We haven't done 4 in a row, unfortunately, no. We've got 3 in a row, but not 4. 4 is still what we're going for. I just don't want to have the same title every day. Sozu's really, really good. Especially with all these shrugs and the battle trance, like, we've got enough card draw to actually make Sozu work well. Black Star is risky. Because we can't upgrade things as well, we can't really make them cheaper. I mean, if I didn't already have the Fusion Hammer, let me think about this. If I didn't already have the Fusion Hammer, I would take Sozu every time. But we do have the Fusion Hammer. We're going to want to be adding things like Barricade, which are like very expensive as well. I'm going to go Sozu. I feel like as much as Black Star can potentially be really good, Relics from Star hopefully make up for non-upgraded cards. Think of all the relics you can get. We don't have much upfront damage. I think we have to go Sozu. We don't have to go Sozu, but I'm gonna go Sozu. Alright, 5 energy. 5 energy, Act 2. Like, I feel like if we go for Black Star, we're gonna get taken low enough where we're gonna have to skip elites. I feel like with this Sozu, I got 5 energy for the rest of the game, and I can probably take on the elites. And not too bad. Oh, yeah, so much block. Tripping Brew, we got Sozu, don't need that garbage. Alright. If you could, you take Sozu with Starring Relic on every character? Yeah. I don't know. I feel like Sozu's better at the end of Act 1. Because, like, potions are more valuable in Act 1 than in any other part of the game. Like, potions kind of, like, diminish in value as the game goes on. So I think getting Sozu after the Act 1 boss is better than getting it at the start. But I'd probably still take it. Skip. Obtain a relic. Random relic. Okay, I'll go for a random relic. Pantograph. Okay, more healing. We don't really need much more healing at the moment, I don't think. Flame Barrier super OP in this fight. Body Slam again. Big. Also, because we can't upgrade the Body Slam. Like, normally you'd upgrade Body Slam and make it zero. But because we can't do that, we kind of need the extra energy. Remove a card from your deck, upgrade all strikes and defense. So, the main benefit of this is that we upgrade our 3 defense to gain 8 block. Which is good with Body Slam. Like, it also leads to more damage. So it's probably upgrade, but then we do continue to remove the strikes even though they're upgraded. Hey Steval, what's going on today? How are we doing? Potions gain value as you get better, as they're pretty difficult to use. I mean, like, you're struggling in a fight, you use the potion, right? I feel like we probably upgrade. It'd be nice to have like one extra defend if we're doing that, but whatever. Probably want the Bane, so I never get it again. It's kind of an annoying fight, to be honest. Don't really want to Fiend that fire, because the smaller deck we have, the more days we're going to draw. Turn here. Damn asshole making me weak all the time. Impervious this one. Trance. Probably defend Uppercut Fiend Fire, to be honest. Means we lose the strike, so. How much damage is Fiend Fire? 7 damage. 7 times 6. Is what, like 42? Definitely Uppercut. Definitely defend. Then. Probably don't Fiend Fire, to be honest. Let's
is a rough turn. Next turn is going to be rough. Oh, nice. Unless it doesn't do anything. Okay, horrible fight that one, but we got through it. Perfected Strike, Carnage, Rupture. Not, it is Perfected Strike plus. 6 damage plus 3 for all your cards containing strike, so it's like 9, 12, 15. So Carnage is still better. I don't hate Carnage, but we don't need it. Right, I think we're going to fight elites. We picked the Sozu so that we can go for all the elites. So let's go. Might want to use Blessing of the Forge this fight. Uppercut Body Slam. Fire here. Again, it's not really enough. We want some, like, block synergy relics. That's what we want. Calipers would be insane. Smooth Stone or whatever it's called. Is it Smooth Stone? Akabeko, that's not great. Havoc, Double Tap, Anger. So we could Double Tap Body Slam, which doesn't really help that much. Skip. 67 health, we can maybe recall here. Oddly Smooth Stone. Yeah, that's the one. Let's recall now. Hey, we got a red key. Did an elite. Stabby Buck. This might be where we want to use the weak potion. Flame Barrier is good against this, although it does bigger multi-attacks later rather than just two. Nice that occasionally we're going to be able to Impervious Body Slam, even though it's maybe not that often. Shrouge. Could Bash Body Slam again, or could just Shrug Body Slam. Probably just block it all. I mean, if we can block it all, why not just do it? Uppercut to keep it weak. Keeping it weak is important. Yeah. Like, the amount of block we got in this deck is really great. Okay, this is a really good Flame Barrier turn.
Huge, destroying it. Nice, bag of marbles. The start of each combat, apply one vulnerable to all enemies. Not that great.
True grit's.
Oh god. There. True grit's really good upgraded, but I can never upgrade it, so I might have to skip. So we'll skip. Chest. Red Skull. When your HP is at or below 50%, you have 3 additional strength. That is not amazing for our deck. We're not taking too much damage. But if we do go low, it could be good. Could we get offered something better in the next one? That's 3 Vajras? Sometimes. Sometimes it's 3 Vajras. I mean, when times get tough, we will be stronger. But most of our damage is going to be Body Slam. Which doesn't really benefit by strength that much anyway. I'm going to take it. I'll take it. Make sure we keep killing the little dudes. Keep killing the little dudes. Okay, it attacks here. Maybe Flame Barrier this turn. Ooh, maybe Impervious this turn. Definitely Impervious this turn. I could double Body Slam the boss for a whole lot of damage. Or I could Body Slam the little dude. Just Body Slam the little dude. And the boss. Now we'd probably just go for the boss. Kill our next turn. Nice. More bank. Whenever you climb a floor, gain 12 gold. Not that great at this stage. Would have been much better earlier on. Pobble Strike Plus, Shockwave Sentinel. Pobble Strike Plus is a pretty good attack. We don't need it. But it's pretty decent. Shockwave. I've just thought of something. Is it less likely that you're going to get upgraded uncommon and rare cards? Like, when you're offered cards, like,
Are the common cards upgraded more often? They probably are. Can you even be offered upgraded rare cards? Maybe you can't. I'm not sure if I've ever been offered up like an upgraded demon form or something. Shockwave is a good card. At the moment I've got one card that applies weak and vulnerable. We could have two cards that apply weak and vulnerable. Shockwave does exhaust as well. It's useless against artifact, but Bash can help get through artifact as well. I quite like the shockwave. Take shockwave. Right, do we want to go for a burning elite? We're definitely strong enough to, I think. I don't normally go for a Burning Elite in Act 2, though. It does seem a bit dicey to go for a Burning Elite in Act 2, but it should be fine. Right. Another body slam. We don't need, like, we don't need loads and loads of body slams. We've already got two. Maybe we just add one more and then leave it at that. Three body slams. And then now we just go for block cards. Oh god, this is a hard fight. Holy shit. Fiend Fire Akabeko. Oh wait, that's actually kind of spicy. Holy shit. Yeah, we could just one-shot something with Fiend Fire and then use Unceasing Top to top deck. So maybe we keep the bad cards so that we exhaust them. Wow, that's pretty smart. Do we ever kill the high health dude? Probably not. Oh, huge impervious top deck. Oh my god. Amazing draw there. Impervious hit the body slap. God damn, that was good. Tank. Nice. If you don't play any attacks, gain additional energy next turn. And we got the green key. Entrench Plus! That goes in the deck. That definitely goes in the deck. Okay, do a couple of events. Get some gold. Event again. Ooh, the Cursed Tome. I mean, in terms of the damage we take, we're about to heal at the boss. We'd probably take this. I think we do this. We're gonna read. So it's either the one where two energy attacks go off twice, the get a random power card at the start of combat, or the one that potentially shuffles a card in your deck, which I don't really like that one. Right, let's read.
Obtain the book! Necronomicon. The first attack played each turn that costs two or more is played twice. Okay. We can always skip the relic at the end. So we get a curse for this. In terms of our two, I mean, this would only work with Uppercut, Fiend, Fire, and Bash. Is it worth having a curse so that Uppercut goes off twice when we play it? I got enough draw that it's probably worth. It's just a curse that doesn't do anything, right? It's not a curse that has a negative effect. Like, if it's a curse that, like, makes us frail, that would be a disaster. But I think it's just a curse that doesn't do anything. Like, if it was a random curse, maybe I wouldn't take it. It can't be removed. Yeah. I think that's fine. The gambling chip prevents a curse on turn one. Yeah, I think we go with the book. Okay. So it works with Bash and Uppercut. Uppercut is the best thing in our deck for it. Does it mean we want to add more 2 energy plus attacks? Not really. Like, even if we get, like, a bludgeon, we just don't really need it. Okay, and we have to heal her anyway. How does Fiendfire work if you have Dead Branch and Necromonomicon? I have no idea. I have absolutely no idea. There is no escape from this curse. Alright, whatever. Uppercut goes off twice, though. Nice shockwave, to be honest. The boss is so weak and so vulnerable. Oh, so they shield the boss. I've only just noticed that. It's the abs that shield the boss. It's not the boss that shields itself. This is definitely a hit the boss turn. Because we hit it pretty hard. Right, I need to find that uppercut again. Need a big block turn next turn. 43 damage. Alright. We'll block a good chunk of that. Just kill that lad. And that was its big turn. So only taking 11 on its big turn, it's not too bad at all. This is not a good turn, though. It's not good when we don't draw any block. One mana slam is so clunky. It is! It's kind of why it's good that we've got 5 energy with the Sozu. I'm pretty glad we picked up the Sozu, to be honest. There we go. Boss dead. Nice. Ah, Bludgeon Limit Break Feed. We're not finding the barricade. Barricade is the single most important thing for us right now. So Bludgeon works with this thing. But we can never upgrade it. It's 64. Mm. We probably had it. I feel like we probably do add it. Alright, I'm gonna add it. Alright. Can we get 6 energy here? Runic Dome, Tiny House, Mark of Pain. Mark of Pain puts the wounds in our deck, which is obviously not good. I'm pretty happy to get to 6 energy. Like, with all these shrugged off, 6 energy is solid. We could just go Runic Dome, though. Because we block so much every turn anyway. Not knowing what the enemy can do is could definitely get me killed. Is that more likely to get me killed than 2 wounds in my deck? It probably is. Like, if we had Barricade, I'd probably go with the Dome. Because then we could focus just fully on block. I'd honestly go for Tiny House here. Tiny House over extra energy. I can't get Runic Dome, man. I'm gonna get Mark of Pain. Damn. 6 energy deck! We're quite a lot of gold, so I won't mind a shop. There's a shop right here. I'll do elites though. There's no way of doing 3 elites. We can only do 2 elites. There's also a shop here. It's quite a nice path actually. If we do like enemy, 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 shop, event, elite, campfire, elite, chest, event, campfire, event, event, event. It's quite nice. Wow, they're all attacking.
Nice. Ghostly armor plus. I mean, it says plus, and it's block card, so yes. Only one of them is attacking. Fiend fire turn one again. That's an upgraded uncommon? It is. Yeah, we've got two upgraded uncommons actually. Oh wait, shit! What did I just do? Oh, I'm an idiot. God damn it. How the hell did I manage that? That's so annoying. Our deck is strong, man. Our deck is strong. Flame Barrier. If we're wondering about how we could beat the Heart, Flame Barrier is really good against the Heart, right? Like, the 4 damage we deal back. If it was upgraded, I would take it. Unupgraded? The fact it's unupgraded now, it's kind of annoying. It's still pretty good against the Heart, though. It's less block than Shrug It Off and Ghostly Armor, though. Because we've got the Wounders in the deck and then Necronomic Curse, we kind of want a bigger deck. We have one. I mean, that's not a good reason to not take another one. It's not the kind of card you only need one of, like... You could take more of them. If I think I'm going to struggle with damage against the Heart. Like, if we play Flame Barrier, the Heart always attacks 15 times, right? So 4 times 15 is, like, 60 damage. So if we play Flame Barrier on one of its multi-attack turns, we block a bit and we deal 60 damage to the Heart. Which is, like... roughly... 8% of its total health. It's just less block than the upgraded cards there now. That's the problem. Like, 2 defenders is more block than Flame Barrier. Oh. Still can get Corruption. I don't think we can take Corruption here, to be honest. I think if we take Corruption, we just run out of cards. Deck isn't that big. I'm gonna skip it. Alright.
Right, we're gonna go to this shop, right? Yeah, let's go to this shop. Or we can skip this shop, do two events. No, I'll do a fight. Oh, these are the kinds of hands that we want. Just a ridiculous amount of block. Just one shot some stuff. Could have killed them with higher health on that. Doesn't really matter. Nice. I mean, we're wrecking these normal fights. Like, these generic fights, we're absolutely smashing them. Skip that. Okay, sure. Oh, we got the war bank. So if we don't spend gold... Apotheosis. Self-forming clay. Actually, it's not that good for us. Do we have any X-cost cards? I don't think so. No. How many cards get upgraded with Apotheosis? Bash, Trance, Bludgeon, all the Body Slams, all the Shrugs. Yeah, I mean... it's gotta be Apotheosis. Evolve. Whenever you draw a status card, draw a card. We probably take Evolve as well. Probably take Evolve as well. It's good for the wounds, it's good for the heart. Like, at this point, I'm just thinking about how do we beat the heart. So it's probably Apotheosis, Evolve, and then either save our gold or remove a card. Apotheosis, Evolve, save gold or remove. There's potentially another shop here, but removing a strike is never bad. Let's remove a strike. Okay. Onwards and upwards. We just got the upgrade all cards one! After we've added Apotheosis. God damn it! This is the kind of deck where we maybe would have gone for the upgrade all cards. Because we've got so much block. We could still do it. Yeah, probably just go for the rare relic. I could have popped it like way lower than that, to be honest. That doesn't really matter. Okay. Bludgeon the level 5/5. Okay. Whenever you apply a vulnerable, apply 1 weak. That's not terrible. I've got 3 cards that apply vulnerable. so it's not terrible. That's the skin. We don't feed fire here, to be honest. Double bludgeon? Or double uppercut? Probably double bludgeon. Just more damage. Attack and weakened. I don't really need Fiend Fire here, to be honest. I'm just gonna exhaust it. Nice body slam draw. In a way, I almost wish Body Slam was 2 energy, so that it would go off twice. With the Necronomicon. Singing Bard, Singing Balls, way too late for that to be good, unfortunately. Although, we will add it here. We might get an extra, you know, 6 max HP or something from that, but it's not a massive deal. So we need the blue key. I do want to do another elite, so we gotta go. We gotta go through the campfire to do that. Just rest. Resting does nothing, but whatever. Okay, right. Which way do we go? Do we want to go through this shop? I don't think we need another shop here. Our first boss fight's time eater. Probably okay. Shop for barricade. Normal enemy fighters. I mean, it could give us card options, which is good for Singing Ball. But then up here, we've still got to do either 3 events or an event or 2 fights. We've got 191 gold, so there's some stuff we can do with that. Probably don't remove a card if we have that option. Okay. Body Slam Plus. Ah! I I've already got 3 body slams. I don't think we need any more. I don't think we need any more. Like, I think I would prefer 1 or 2 more block cards. These get upgraded by Apotheosis anyway. It's like, may as well treat these as if they're almost upgraded body slams. Not quite, but... I don't think we take it. Go with the HP. I'll take Lukey here. Dreamcatcher, that's a garbage one anyway, so that's fine. Entrench. Clockwork Souvenir. Entrench is just really good. Even unupgraded is quite good. Because of the Apotheosis. I can't quite afford remove a card and entrench. I think I'm gonna go entrench. And not do anything else. We can just do humongous damage to the boss here. It's risky strat though. Risky, risky. We could massively regret this. This is sketchy. We could actually regret this massively. So we'll do 60, then the second one won't do quite as much damage, right? So this can do what, like... the other one I would do 32. It's like 108 damage. This is 108 damage. And then the strikes do 25 each. Yeah, it's easy, easy. Just damage the boss. Oh wait, not quite 25 each. Oh shit. I miscalculated. Holy fuck! I miscalculated. I've got no damage here. Oh no. Oh shit. Don't tell me we're gonna die now. This deck was so good. No, no. Oh no. Why did I do that? That was so dumb. That was so dumb. Oh, I'm such an idiot. I'm gonna die. I'm literally gonna die. I can't believe I just did that. What do we have coming up? Events. Oh god. 7 energy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can't just play my whole hand here. Wait, why did that just play twice? Oh, it's just the champion bell effect. Oh, okay. I don't know what's going on there. So hard there. Right, we're gonna have to heal this all back up now. God damn it. Right, an event. Oh, before the, we would just definitely do this. Now I'm not so sure. We'd probably just do it still, but it's way more dicey now. Okay, let's do it. Ah! We just play evolve. I mean, it's not really a fight where you have much time. It's kind of nice to play evolve, though. Perdiosis. I could just battle Transfiend Fire. Whenever you play a power card, heal 2 HP. Searing Blow, Disarm, Pummel Strike. Disarm is okay against the heart, but we don't need it as much because we've got a lot of block. And we have a lot of weak as well. So I might just give it the HP here. HP. Right, events or fights? Events. A shop. Offering. Another shrug.
no barricade. I'm thinking about just going off rogue and shrug it off here. But if we save our gold, we do have a chance to get barricade in the last shop before the heart. I think I'm just gonna do offering shrug. I don't know how much offering would cost. I mean, barricade would cost. Would I even be able to afford it? Let's just do sure off, right? Okay. Event. Oh, I hate this thing. I hate this thing. We didn't do that many attacks either. So do we even want to do Body Slam Fiend Fire? We could Body Slam? And if it's really bad Fiend Fire. Or I could just chill. We could just chill. Take it easy. Someone explain what this enemy does. I never lost to it. It's got a bunch of random attacks. And it every time you damage it, it changes. There's like some big attacks and small attacks. There's one that puts a curse in your deck permanently. Okay, 20 damage, we can block that. That's neat. It's not neat. The opposite of neat. Six times three. Like here, I could just take the six times three and not risk it turning into something bad. Yeah. Just chill. Don't risk it. Don't risk it. Bludgeon should be lethal. Nice. Right, barricade. That's a skip. Oh, what about True Grit? Because it will get upgraded with Apotheosis now. Nah. Okay, here we go. Boss time. I don't know if this deck's good enough to beat the heart. This deck's good. This deck's good, but we don't have that. Like, without the barricade, losing our block every turn, we've got to rebuild our block again with the heart. It damages us every time. Like, this is going to be hard. We've got no gold to spend in this last shot now. Time Eater is probably a pretty easy fight for us. It's a bad hand though. It's a really bad hand actually.
I don't hate Fiendfire this turn. We lose Offering, but we get rid of the Wound and the Curse. So it seems like a pretty good Fiendfire. Wait! What?! We can't even exhaust it! That's bullshit! What?! You can't even exhaust it! Okay. Reading too hard? Oh yeah, because there is no escape means the exact same thing as cannot be exhausted, obviously. Totally obvious. How dumb of me to not realize that. Right. Entrench. Three cards here. Okay. Do we ever go for like... No, we probably just chill, right? There's a chance we could get like a ridiculous double entrenched body slam turn. But probably don't go for it. Man, maybe we could have got it. I don't know that much damage is done, probably better to just not do it. 12 times 3. I do like up making it weak here. Like, I'm thinking about doing double uppercut over double bludgeon. Like, I can either do double bludgeon, uppercut, defend. I gotta be careful about the timer as well. 6. Yeah, let's play it safe. And just block next turn, if we can. Barrier and trench. Okay, now I'll try and get some big block going on. Nice. Close to lethal here. Nice! A lot more than lethal. Okay, do we heal? We do heal at the start of the fight, nice. Wait, so you can't exhaust it, but you can discard it. So you can escape it. You can escape it, you just discard it. Bam, escaped. Right. Shrug it off. Ghostly armor offering. Discard isn't escape, it's still in the deck. No, no, it's gone. We escaped it. It's gone. It's not in my hand. I can't see the stream, so I've escaped it. Thank you. Jackie runs away from the Terminator once and thinks he's forever safe. Does that mean if no one is looking at me, I cease to exist? Yeah, you do cease to exist to every single other person in the world except yourself. That is how it works. Alright. This thing's kind of annoying. I'm not currently looking at Syndra, and he still exists in my world. Aww. Aww. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have evolved here, but we can probably just beat this anyway. Man, after you've played Time Eater, it's always like such a relief to be able to actually just play your cards. Evolve is definitely worth it. I don't want to use Impervious just yet, I don't think. Easy bludge. Big bludge. Love a big bludge. Oh man, evolve is so nuts. Big bludge. Okay. Huge slaps, nice. I think we probably got the right amount of body slams. We maybe could have done with one more. We maybe could have got away with one more, but we don't really need it. Don't really need one more. Oh no! We drew the void, we've only got 5 energy. Disaster. Five energy is basically zero. Okay. Dead. Very dead. Right. Jackie's throwing. We did throw one fight. There was one fight we really messed up. But we're making it through. Can we beat the heart with this deck? I don't know. If we had, like, if we literally had one card, if we had Barricade, I would feel confident we're going to beat the heart. And this elite to come. Without Barricade, I don't feel so confident. To be fair, I don't think this elite needs Barricade so much. Because this elite attacks, like, every turn. Because the heart has turns where it doesn't attack. Like, you want to build up the block on the turns where it doesn't attack. Don't tell me there's a barricade in this shop and we can't afford it. Okay, there's no barricade. Feel no pain. Alright, moving on. Can't afford anything. Let's go. Maybe this elite gives us barricade. Shockwave isn't an attack, so no. Necronomicon is the only thing that makes it go off twice. Still applying vulnerable applies weak though, which is very good for me. Well, that's a hand. A shit hand. Thankfully, we killed that. God damn it. Entrench. Entrench. Ooh, damn. 0000. Who made that up? Whose idea was it to make 0000? Asshole. Okay. Spodiosis, double shrug. Double uppercut, sorry. Hey, evolve is nice. Evolve turn one would have been really good. Wow, we handled that fight with ease. With ease. Right, we're gonna add a card to our deck. And it's gonna be Barricade. Do you get like even increased odds of getting rare cards in this fight? You probably don't, right? It's probably just like fighting a normal elite card reward. Ah, please, Barricade, 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 Barricade! No Barricade. If he gets Barricade, I sub. Oh, damn. That's a double lose for me. No Barricade and no sub. Feels bad, man. probably shrug it off. Shrug. Warpaint. Double shrug. Right, can we beat the heart? So, I think we just get rid of all of this crap. We need to find a Apotheosis. And, what do we need? Apotheosis and evolve turn one. Nope. Alright. 100 health down. Really rough. Holy shit, we drew the void already.
Utravelsky just resubscribed for 21 months. I sub even without Barricade. Gotta be there for the tough times.
Hey, Utravelsky, welcome out of the Jackals. Thank you very much. Cheers. I mean, we have to play about the Osis. There's no way we don't play this. And then what is it? It's double defend or shockwave. It has to be shockwave. And we take a million damage already. Alright. This is not really doable, I don't think. Feed fire. Definitely play
Major underscore Porkins just resubscribed for 18 months. New game when? Pause chat.
Hey Major Porkins, welcome back to the Jackoffs. Thank you very much, cheers. New game, definitely not until we've got four in a row. We have to get four wins in a row, one with each character. That has to be done. The four in a row is to win with all four classes, yeah. In a row. Back to back.
So let me do Fiend Fire here. We get rid of a lot of the bad cards, do a bit of damage. Our health is just such a problem. It's just the beat of the heart is so hard to combat here. Entrench here, but then we probably get wrecked next turn. Man, barricade would beat the heart. Barricade would have beat the heart. Or calipers. Barricade or calipers. 3 times 15. Can we block this? It's a lot of damage. Entrench with double shrug is not a bad start. I need more block. Defend. Okay. Wait, what is 3 times 15? It's 45. So if I defend, we do block all of it. Okay. Or we could entrench bludgeon. Double bludgeon is a lot of damage. I think I'm gonna block. Five damage. Okay. Do we just impervious shrug body slam? Do we want to apply more weak and vulnerable? We could bash. We could do bash, impervious body slam. Only strip one artifact. No, we've got the we've got champion belt, right? So it should apply weak, vulnerable, weak, vulnerable, weak, right? Because it goes off twice with Necronomicon. No? What do you mean no? Champion works if you apply Vuln. Wait. Oh. Damn, that sucks. It's still good to get rid of the artifact. Yeah, I don't have the uppercut anymore, though. So we don't have any way of applying vulnerable or weak, except doing bash again. So. I think we just go for a big body slam. Hope we draw enough block next turn. And 12 damage slam. Right, we probably got 2 turns to kill it here.
And we are not killing it here. This is a bad outcome. We're not going to kill it in two turns, I don't think. This is a bad outcome. Only doing 35 damage that turn means we probably die this next turn. 6 times 15, yeah. We could potentially draw a trench. Oh. Oh! We're just gonna keep shrugging. We have to try and block it out. Keep shrugging, shrugging away. Wait, what's 6 times 15? It's like 90. If we entrench body slam. Wait, do we take the damage before the entrench effect? No, it's after, right? So we should get 80 and then lose 2. So like 80 minus 2 is 78. 76 plus 17. 76 plus 17 is like, oh, I don't know, like 93? So I think we're good. I think we entrenched body slam. Okay. Wait! What? Did I do maths wrong? Oh no! What? I swear I did maths right. What? What did I do? You forgot the burn. Burn! 3 HP from ticks. Wait, the heart was doing 3 damage? Oh, I didn't realize it was doing 3 damage. Shit! Oh, we were so close! I didn't realize it was doing 3. So, wait, when does it start doing 3? On that big 6 attack turn? Is that it? After the second buff. So the second buff, it buffs its hot, its beat. Oh, that's so brutal. This was such a good run. I mean, without barricade, with barricade, it would have been an easy win, right? Without barricade, it was hard, but we almost did it. We almost did it even without barricade. So close. So close. The turn was calculated, but man, Jack's bad at math. I mean, I'm not bad at math. Like, I did the right math, I just didn't realize it was doing 3 damage. And I didn't realize the burn was there. So I just missed a few things. Right, okay, let's play Silent.